Hello, this is Hiroshi Amazoe. In this video, I will talk about how to deal with depression by modifying the meals that we eat daily. I have been experimenting many things to reduce my depression without taking antidepressants for a long time. And in the previous videos,I have shared several ways to cope with depression without taking antidepressants. And in those videos, I mainly introduced the fact that cardio exercise and exposure to sunlight can reduce depression. First, let's take a look back on these methods a little before I get to the main topic.In the previous videos, I have introduced that walking outdoors in the sunlight or doing cardio exercise can reduce depression. This is because physical exercise produces serotonin, a neurotransmitter that helps to create a positive mood, and exposure to sunlight produces melatonin, a hormone that helps people fall fast asleep at night, sleep well, improve the quality of our sleep. Lack of sleep makes us feel irritable, apathetic, and depressive often. So a good quality sleep has positive effects mentally. And about exercise, I have found that although I don't like to exercise when I am depressed,If I do exercise, I found that my depression is significantly reduced. And I have experienced that many times, especially 30 to 60 minutes of cardio exercise at the gym can really make me feel better when I am depressed. And walking about 8,000 steps outdoors a day will make me easier to fall asleep and sleep well at night and regulate my sleep cycle. But I think it is important to note that too much exercise may have the opposite effect. In my experience, too much fatigue can make it difficult to sleep. And if you are too tired,You will remain tired the next day and you will become apathetic and depressed in next day. So, therefore, I think it is best for each person to find the amount of exercise that is suitable, not too hard and not too easy, and sustain that amount of exercise. I think it is better.And also, overexposure to sunlight is not good for the body because it has containing ultraviolet rays. So in summer, it is better to take protection against ultraviolet rays and to avoid prolonged exposure to the sun. And now I will talk about the main topic of this video. It is a technique for reducing depression that I will mention for the first time on my channel. It is a technique to reduce depression by modifying our daily eating habits. There are two main things I do regarding this. The first thing is to reduce the amount of carbohydrates.Technically, carbohydrates also include fiber, but the problem is not the fiber you take by salad and etc., but the saccharides in the carbohydrates. But since saccharides are generally called as carbohydrates, so I will use the word carbohydrates for it. So, carbohydrates are contained a lot in rice, bread, ramen, pasta, and other noodles, and etc. When too much carbohydrates are consumed to our body, a sudden spike in blood glucose levels occurs. This will cause sudden fatigue, sleepiness, and loss of concentration. So I keep my breakfast and lunch very low in carbohydrates. This actually works for me. I used to eat 3 meals a day, all of which consisted largely of carbohydrates. I had fairly no problem in the morning, but after lunch, I would sometimes suffer from severe fatigue and even need to lie down for a bit. But since I started reducing carbohydrates, that symptom has disappeared. I almost never feel tired after lunch anymore. And instead of reducing carbohydrates, I now often eat more eggs and fishes. And by the way, it has been said that eating many eggs is bad for our health because it raises cholesterol levels and triggers arteriosclerosis. But according to recent studies, eating eggs does not affect cholesterol levels much because the majority of cholesterol is produced by the liver, not from the foods we eat. And if we eat a cholesterol-rich food, the liver adjusts by producing less cholesterol. So the level of cholesterol in the foods does not matter much. In fact, in Japan, the Ministry of Health, Labor and Welfare eliminated the maximum cholesterol limit from the ideal dietary intake standards in 2015. But in any case, I think it's not good to eat too much. For example, if we eat 10 eggs a day, the nutritional intake will be unbalanced and not good for your health. And the second thing is omega-3 fatty acids. Omega-3 fatty acids are found in fish such as sardines, mackerel, and celery, and etc. This is a nutrient that is necessary for the brain to function well, and is considered useful in reducing depression. It also prevents blood clots and reduces inflammation. The effect to reducing depression has been clarified by a number of well-known research institutions. In Japan, the National Cancer Center conducted a large-scale study in 2018. And announced that omega-3 fatty acids have an effect of reducing anxiety. In addition, the Japanese Society of Psychiatry and Neurology introduced that it has therapeutic effects on mood disorders, dementia, and depression. Also, many studies about it have been conducted overseas too. But among the results of those studies, there is a study that shows that it has almost no effect on reducing depression. But even if there is a small effect, I think it is worthwhile to include it as a part of our daily routine to cope with depression. So I have started eating less carbohydrates and more fish, which contains omega-3 fatty acids. But honestly, I have not really noticed any effect of omega-3 fatty acids. There may be small effects, but I'm not sure. But I have certainly noticed a change in my condition due to the reduction of carbon hydrates. My fatigue and sleepiness after lunch is greatly reduced, and I can be more active and less depressed. And at night, on the contrary, I eat carbon hydrates normally. This is because I sleep after dinner, and it is more desirable if I could fall fast asleep. And this is also works well. So, if you are feeling tired and sleepy during the day, which makes you less active and triggers depression, it might be a good idea to reduce carbohydrates on your breakfast and lunch. So this time I talked about how to reduce depression by modifying the foods we eat. And if you know of some other good coping techniques for depression, I would appreciate it if you could share it through comments. It will be helpful to people. And maybe in another video, I will introduce your method of coping with depression. So thank you for watching, and I will continue to post more and more various videos. If you are interested, please subscribe to my channel. See you in the next video.